Deathrattle skeleton warriors are the backbone of the undead. Mindless and without mercy, they slay the enemies of their Lord Nagash. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint one of these models. We painted them in the contrast method, and we painted them up to battle ready. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Wraith Bane, which is perfect for this colour scheme. Now, the first colour we're going to use is going to be Skeleton Horde. So I'm going to give the pot a quick shake, pop it open. And for this, I'll be using a medium shade brush because I'm going to coat over most of the model. So what I'm going to do is just dip it in like so. Apply a little bit to my palette, more just so I don't overload the brush too heavily and just get a decent point to it. And all I'm going to then do is just start applying it all over the bone. So I'm going to apply it all over the model, but where his sword is and his metal skirt, I'm just going to try and avoid that as best as I can. And if I do get any on there, I'll just tidy back up with some Wraith Bone. And there we are with the bone details now painted and the skirt and the sword tidy back up with Wraith Bone. We're going to start applying the other contrast on. Now we're going to start with our silicanum grey, which will be for the metal areas. For the gold areas or the brass details, we're going to be using gore grunter fur. For the red cloth, we'll be using blood angel red, and we're going to finish off doing the black details or the leather, and for that we'll be using black templar. So let's start with that silicanum grey. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. Again, this is more just to load up the brush to get a nice point. And again, we're just going to be doing those metal areas, so this is going to be the sword and the skirt. So I'm just going to start with the sword, and I'll move on to the skirt after. The metal area is done, we're now going to use Gore Grunter for the shield to make it look brassy. Now that the Gore Grunter fur is dry, we're going to move on to applying some Blood Angel Red. I'm going to do this on his skirt. With the red cloth now done, we're going to move on to painting the black leather, and for this we'll be using Black Templar. So again, just using a small brush, just go around those bits of leather. If you make any mistakes, just neaten back up with Wraith Bone, then just reapply your contrast paint. There we are with the black leather done. We're now going to move on to applying some texture to the base. And for this, we'll be using Aguilon Badlands. So I'm just going to grab my texture tool. Just going to grab a little bit out of the pot. Just using the large side here just to scoop some up. And all I'm going to then do is just start applying that to the base. That's mainly just to get it on. And then all I'm going to do is move around to the smaller side. Just give me more control around those feet. Once this is dry, you want to leave it for about an hour to dry. You can start rimming the base. And for this, I'll be using Steel Legion Drab. And there we are with the texture now dry and the rim painted. This Deathrattle Skeleton Warrior is battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using contrasts on a Skeleton Warrior, it's worth starting with the bone first, and you can always add the other colours after, such as the cloth and the metal. And secondly, when using contrast, try not to overload your brush because it could quickly run out of control, so just be as neat as you can and take your time. And if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Wraith Bone and just reapply those contrasts after. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Skeleton Warriors, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.